Audio Jungle.
Lilibet Diana, the youngest child of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, has yet to make her debut on UK soil after her birth in Santa Barbara, California, in June. With no picture of the child available publicly, speculation about what the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are planning for her christening has been rife. NBC royal correspondent Neil Sean claimed it is unlikely Lilibet Diana will have her day at St. George's Chapel in Windsor because of the alleged intervention of a senior royal family member. Mr. Sean claimed, "One of the bigger problems that Meghan really encountered of later is that she wanted her daughter, Lilibet Diana, to be christened in the place she was married alongside her husband Prince Harry. And then the christening of her firstborn, Archie. But that came to a grinding halt. Both Harry and Meghan were very keen to make that return and make sure that christening happened, particularly in front of Her Majesty the Queen. Some people may say they're just capitalizing on their royal connection, and why not? It's how they make money now. But moving forward, there was one person who basically decided there wasn't an appetite for this, and the person that seemingly is, so far, not willing to kiss and make up with his younger brother." He further claimed, according to a very good source, "Prince William was the one who basically said, 'No, we don't think this is going to work. It wasn't a particularly good idea.'" Kensington Palace has declined to comment. Prince William's relationship with his younger brother Prince Harry has been fraught in recent years, and the brothers have not spent much time together since the Duke of Sussex stepped down from his working royal role in March 2020. The pair were briefly reunited twice this year, first at Prince Philip's funeral in April, where they were seen exchanging a few words thanks to Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge's intervention, and then again in July at the unveiling of a statue commemorating their late mother, Princess Diana. Over the summer, a friend of the Princess of Wales claimed the brothers had been slowly restarted communications over Zoom. Stuart Pearce suggested Kate and Meghan Markle had also been playing a pivotal role in helping their husbands reconnect, albeit virtually. Mr. Pearce said, "I know that the four are talking with one another, and they're talking by Zoom FaceTime. They're very close with one another. And what's remarkable is that they all totally respect each other, but this lens is different. It's not William and Kate's responsibility to be involved in, you know, verbalizing anything. What they do is just simply offer as much peace and tranquility and calm as possible." Prince Harry and Meghan Markle announced their decision to take a step back from active royal work in March 2020 and confirmed the decision to step down indefinitely after a one-year trial. The couple shortly set up home in Canada following a six-week break from royal duty in the autumn of 2019, which they said they would use to spend time with their then six-month-old son Archie Harrison. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex later relocated to California before international travel was shut down because of the coronavirus pandemic. Neither Meghan Markle nor her son have returned to the UK since, and Lilibet Diana has yet to be introduced to members of the royal family in person. Another news: the Duchess of Cambridge, 39, has shared new tennis-themed video with fans while her brother-in-law Prince Harry, 37, and his wife Meghan Markle, 40, are visiting New York. The Sussexes are currently carrying out their first trip with formal meetings and public visits since their step back from royal duties in 2020. Kensington Royal, the official Twitter account for Kate and her husband Prince William, 39, shared footage promoting the work of the LTA Youth Initiative as Harry and Meghan visited a school in the Big Apple on Friday. The scheme, support by the Duchess, is a progressive tennis program for children aged 4 to 18. Alongside footage of the Duchess of Cambridge interacting with young people playing the sport, the Cambridge's Twitter account explained the role LTA youth plays. They said, "Hashtag LTA Youth paving the way for the next generation of tennis players. By helping children enjoy the benefits of playing and staying in tennis, whatever their ages, gender, ability, disability or background, it plays a vital role for the future of grassroots sport across the country." It comes following news that the Duchess wowed spectators as she joined US Open tennis champ Emma Raducanu on the court for a doubles match. Kate, who is a keen tennis fan, met with the 18-year-old earlier today, and video footage showed the pair playing together, as they formed one team in a doubles match. The royal played alongside the tennis star at the National Tennis Centre in London, during a homecoming event for its tennis stars. The footage was met with delight from royal fans who shared their happiness at seeing the royal mother of three taking to the court. One user, at Laurie_E, extended his thanks to the duo saying, "I'm so impressed by the involvement of Catherine and Emma today. I think every child in the country would like to take up tennis. Thank you both." Their thoughts were reiterated by Agena67169, who tweeted what an inspiration they both are in promoting sports across the country. "The Duchess and Emma, congratulations to them both. While at Loveroff UK shared their hopes for more tennis-related content from the royal, saying, "I am loving the video. Congratulations to all the UK tennis players. I would love to see Catherine host and play in a tennis charity match," a sentiment which seemed to resonate with others as at Jen Carson Taylor said, "A great way to promote sport. Love this spotlight on tennis. Love our sporting duchess." And at Dancing Infinite One added, "These kids are having fun at this event. As usual, Duchess of Cambridge connects so great with all of them," along with a series of clapping hands and heart eye emojis. The footage was shared while Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are on day two of a three-day visit to New York. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle surprised students at a Harlem school on Friday, September 24, as their latest public outing on their Big Apple visit. During the visit, the Duchess read her book The Bench to students, aged 7 and 8. The visit to PS 123 Mahalia Jackson saw the couple joining school's Chancellor Maisha Porter to highlight school initiatives and to promote early literacy.